Hi students, let us today see how to calculate HCF using Euclid's division. This is another method which is also popularly known as the long division method. We have already learned how to calculate the HCF using one of the prime factorization methods, which is a repeated division method. So knowing one more method, it definitely adds to our confidence levels. So let us today see the new method, which is our Euclid's division method. If we have a group of numbers, like let us first take two numbers. So to find the HCF of 24 and 32, we are going to do a division. So as we have only two numbers, I'm writing the larger number as my dividend and the smaller number as my divisor. And let us start dividing. So our remainder can be a zero, or sometimes it may not be a zero. Let us see what will happen. I can use 24 once is 24, and as you see, my remainder is a 8, which is not a zero. Now when your remainder is not a zero, what you have to do is you will make your remainder as your next divisor, and your dividend would be your 24 now, the previous divisor, and you need to repeat this process till your remainder is a zero. As we know, 8 threes is 24 and our remainder is a zero. So 8 is the HCF of 24 and 32. Let us try this using one more example. So let us now take the numbers 24 and 60. Let us see what is the HCF. As usual, we'll take the larger number as the dividend and the smaller number as the divisor. 24 twos is 48. 24 threes is 72 would be more. So I'm using 24 twos is 48. And I ended up with the remainder. So now what you have to do, your remainder becomes your new divisor and the previous divisor becomes your new dividend. You need to repeat this process till your remainder is a zero. And this is exactly divisible. 12 twos is 24 and the remainder is a zero. So the remainder is a zero when our divisor is a 12. So this is our HCF. So the HCF of 24 and 60 is a 12. Would you like to try it out? So I would like to give you a combination of numbers. Find the HCF of 48 and 80. Hope you got the HCF of 48 and 80. Now let us see if we can use the same Euclid's division method if we have three numbers, or if you are having more than three numbers also. Let our numbers be 24, 48 and 60. Now how should we start? Pick any two numbers of your choice. I would like to choose 24 and 48, and I'm going to use the division method. 48 would be my dividend and 24 is my divisor, and we know that 24 twos is 48, which is exactly divisible. So the HCF of 24 and 48 is a 24, but we have to find the HCF of three numbers. Now we will take this 24, and the number which we have left out is a 60. Let us divide our 60 also with a 24, and let us see if it can divide exactly. We have taken a 24 because our remainder was a 0 for the previous two numbers. If it was not a 0, you need to repeat this process and find out the divisor which is able to exactly divide your numbers. You're going to use that number over here. So for 24 and 48, the remainder was a 0 and the divisor is 24. So I am using the 24 over here. Now let us start our division. 24 twos is 48 and our remainder is a 12. So the remainder is not a 0. So I am going to repeat the process. So this becomes my new divisor and the previous divisor is my dividend. And we know that 12 twos is 24 and it is exactly divisible. So this is our HCF, and by the way, 12 is the HCF of all the three numbers. This is how you apply the Euclid's division method for three numbers. I was just thinking, our group of numbers were 24, 48 and 60, and we started with a 24 and 48. Is it always that we have to start with the smallest numbers in our group, or can we pick up any two numbers in our list? So I have decided to try it out now with 24 and 60 first, and I am going to take my 48 in the later phase. Let us see what will happen. So when I divide my 60 with a 24, 24 twos is 48 and our remainder is a 12. Now because it is not a 0, I am going to divide my 24 now. I have made the previous divisor as my dividend. And we know that 12 twos is 24 and the remainder is a 0. So the HCF of 24 and 60 is a 12. Now we are going to make this as a new divisor, and whatever number we have left out is a 48. Let us check what is the HCF we are going to get. And we know that 48 is exactly divisible by a 12. 12 fours is a 48. So the HCF of all three numbers is a 12. So we can pick our numbers in any order which we are comfortable. So I am very sure you must be wondering how come this long division method is working, where we are trying to use the remainder as our divisor and we were trying to find the highest common factor. So let us try to understand this using an activity. So here I am trying to find the HCF of 28 and 20. So what I have done is, I have taken a Lego base with the block size of 28 and also block size of 20 dots on it. And let us try to understand this method. So the Euclid's division method says that you will take your larger number as your dividend and you are going to divide with a 20. So 20 ones is 20 and your remainder is a 8. Let us do this using our Legos too. So this is my 28 block and this is my 20. I will keep this upon the 28 one. I have used 21 block. So 20 ones is 20 and my remainder is my 8 dots. Now what are we trying to do? We are trying to divide this, the previous divisor, as our, we are making it as our dividend, and we are trying to divide with an 8. 8 ones is 8, 8 twos is 16 and our remainder is a 4. Now what should we do? Because we are left with this 8, I'm taking a Lego base of 8 and now I will divide my divisor, because this was our previous divisor. I'm making this as my dividend and I'll see how many such blocks are required. I've just kept one block. 8 ones is 8. I think I can fit more such blocks. 8 2's is 16, but I cannot fit my third block on the red one because red one is our new dividend. So I'm going to stop over here and my remainder is a 4. Did you see? We have got 4 dots on the red one. Now what should you do? What is your new divisor now? Your remainder is your new divisor. So I'm going to take a Lego base of 4. So this is my new divisor and my dividend becomes my white color. So I will try to now see what is going to happen. So now we have to proceed further over here. You would have done your base, your dividend is your 8 and your divisor is a 4. That means my single white color, I'm going to fill it. I need not fill this one, isn't it? Because we have used two such blocks. Let us see if this size block, a block size of 4, can fill the white one. This is 4 ones and 4 twos. As you can see, it is able to fill the white one. So if we continue with our division also, we can see that 4 twos is 8 and our remainder is a 0. So 4 is our highest common factor. The HCF of 28 and 20 is a 4. So how is this working? So let us try to understand what exactly we have done. We have started with the 28 and we also had a 20, and we were trying to see if we 20 can exactly fit our 28, which it cannot do. As you can see, when I placed it over here, some portion of our 28 is remaining, and if I take another 20 block, it would be more. And we stopped over here and we took this remaining portion, which is our 8, and we were trying to check if this 8 can exactly divide my 20. If it was able to exactly divide 20, think that if your 8 was able to exactly fill till over here, your 8 can fill the remaining portion also, which means that 8 was able to fill completely your 20 block, and 8 would completely fill your 28 too. So then in that case, the HCF would be an 8, but which is not in this case. So we were trying to figure out, we were trying to take a block of the remainder size, and we were trying to check if it can fill our blocks. So now the remainder is now again a 4. Now we started to fill our 8 with a 4, and you can see that your 4 can completely fill your 8. Your 4s can fill your 8, which means that your 4s can fill your 8. Your same 4 can fill your 20. 20 is till here. And your 4 can fill your 28 also. That is how the Euclid's division method is working.